Almighty God, we come unto you this day asking for the gift of your grace, but also that you help us to hear from you in your word this morning. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit.
Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. God is desiring people who want to be holy, who want to do what is right in His eyes, no matter the cost. Blessed are the merciful. Are we willing to extend mercy to those who hurt us, those who persecute us, to those who offend us? When we do, we are extending the mercy of Jesus. Remember what He said when He was on the cross. Father, forgive them. For they don't know what they're doing. Can you imagine? Nailed to the cross, whipped 39 times, bleeding, suffocating. And He forgives the people who put Him on the cross. How can we do less? Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. I don't know about you, but I'm not pure in heart. I read that and I shudder, wondering how that's ever possible. But you know, the truth of the matter is, God cleanses our hearts. It's nothing that we can do. That's why I raise my hand and say, I know I'm not pure in heart. But when God says, I forgive you, He cleanses my heart. He makes us. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called sons of God. I guess the question we need to ask ourselves, am I a peacemaker? Or am I one who causes turmoil? Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. I think those two blessings are tied together. Blessed are the righteous, and blessed are those who are love God. Basically saying, blessed are you when you love me. When you love me, says Jesus. Because you will be persecuted. We've had it kind of easy here in the United States of America. Freedom of religion has been something that we've been able to take for granted. But guess what? We're losing one small piece at a time. We need to be ready for real persecution because it's coming. And then Jesus wraps it up with this before He goes on with other teaching. Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. Jesus wants us to rejoice in all of these things that He just mentioned, every single beatitude. Because He knows that when we are able to say yes to all of these, that we are right where He wants us. His holy, faithful people, loving Him and loving others as we are called to. And so then we can say with joy, I'm looking forward to heaven. So I want to call all of us to remember that we are saints, and we are to live like saints every day, every minute of every day, knowing that we're being watched by those who do not believe. Let us pray.
I haven't.
Okay, good. little